Good day, YouTube. So, as promised, I'm gonna start my series today on how to do plain and solid geometry in the AutoCAD program. So, I'm using the 2015 version. It is pretty much the same as the 2016, 2017, 2018 versions. So, you can always follow along if that is the program or version that you have. So this is what AutoCAD is going to look like when you open it. This is the interface. We have the start drawing area, open files, and then we have the recent documents. So if you have worked on something before, this is where it is going to appear. So when we open the drawing, or when we open the program, we're going to see this here, so we can click on start drawing if we want to start a new drawing. And it is going to open up the actual AutoCAD interface. Taking a little time, but this is what AutoCAD is going to look like when you click on the start drawing icon. So because you are here, it means that you are already acquainted with the AutoCAD program. So I'm not going to go into all of the details as to what the icons mean and whatever else. You should already be at a certain level of AutoCAD to follow me very closely. So please permit me to just go straight into the video in teaching you how to at least do a basic setup. Alright, so what I usually teach students the first time around is that you need to set up your drawing before you even start. So in order for us to set up our drawing, we're going to click on the menu, and we're going to go down to drawing utilities, and that is going to open up a list where we are going to click on units. So in the units, we will be able to tell AutoCAD what units we want to use for our entire drawing from henceforth. So we have different sections. We have the length section, the angle section, the insertion scale section, sample output, lighting. So what we want to focus on for our purposes is the length section and the insertion scale section and the angle section. So for the length section, we are going to be using decimal units. So as you can see, it says set the current format for unit measure and so on and so forth. So we're going to leave it as decimal because we do not want to use architectural units, we do not want to use engineering units. We want our units to be simple decimal numbers. Okay, so that's what our length is going to be. So we're going to click decimal, and for precision we don't want to use any decimals. So we're just going to leave it as 0 for now. We don't want multiple decimal places, so we're just going to leave it as 0 for now. So our insertion scale is very important because that tells us what units we are going to be using. And by default it is set to inches, and we are going to change that to millimeters because in my part of the world, which is St. Lucia, we follow the metric system. I know the British also follow the metric system as well, and we want to keep it simple as the metric system because we know that is a standard unit of measurement where it is recognized worldwide. So we want to keep it standard, and we're gonna leave it as millimeters. Right now in angle, decimal degrees is set by default, and that is what we're going to leave it as. As you can see, there is degrees, minutes and seconds, there is gradients, radians and surveyors units. So we don't want to focus on any of these, but we want to specially choose decimal degrees because it is simple and also standard. Our precision will also leave it as 0, and our direction we're gonna leave it as anti-clockwise because our degrees are gonna be measured in this direction. If you can see the mouse, it is moving in the anti-clockwise direction. And that is the direction we usually read our angles. Okay, so zero will be here, and when you, the more you move this way, the angle is going to increase. So here will be 90, then we will have 180, 270, and back to zero. So we're going to leave it as anti-clockwise for now. If it is clockwise, then of course it will go in the other direction, but we want to leave it as clockwise for now. So we are done editing our join unit, so we can now close this window and we can get ready to draw. But even before we go into the drawing, we want to set up our layers, and these are the two things that we are going to focus on for this video. We looked at the units, and now we're going to look at the layers, to set up our layers. Now this is the layers area, and on layer properties, when we click that icon, we can actually put in our different layers. And for those of you who do not know what layers are a simple steps in a drawing where you can have different sections of a drawing. So say for example, I want to put all of my object lines in one layer. I'll be able to edit my object lines without tampering with my construction lines, for example. So these are just two of the layers that we are going to be entering into our system. So to enter a new layer, right here we have as you can see, something that looks like a stack of papers, and it has a yellow star on it. We click that, and that is going to allow us to edit a new layer. So we see layer one, we can delete that, and we can start typing in the names of our layers. So the first layer is going to be object lines, and I press enter. Now if I press enter again, you see layer one coming up. So the more we press enter, the more new layers we can create. Instead of going to click here all the time, we can just press enter and enter again, and it will allow us to continue creating new layers. So our next layer is going to be construction lines. Okay, and now these lines are lines that are going to be hopefully at the beginning of every drawing, and that is going to help us to form our final product. So the next one, in any order, I have dimensions, and I have text, I have hidden lines. Oops, what did I do? Okay, let's go back on that. Hidden lines. And I also have construction arc. Okay, these are also very important. Now I usually put multiple arcs, so I'm going to name this one construction arc 1, and I'm going to name the next one construction arc 2, then construction arc 3. Now we can put more than one depending on our preference, but this is what we're gonna have for now. Now I put in my text here, I'm not even seeing it. Let me do it again. Text, my text layer. Okay, so as time goes by, we will add more layers, but let's just start with these for now. And what we can also do in this this dialog box is that we can change the color of our layers, because we do not want a case where we are changing our layers but then all of the layers are the same color and then we get confused. So what we can do is to change the colors of the layers, so that when we see the color, we'll say, okay, I'm in this layer, so let me make sure that I remember to change my layer when the time comes. So object lines, I usually put them as red, so we can see the colors coming up, and I can choose my color red. press OK, and at once it changes color in the color column. Then construction lines, I usually put them as cyan, so I click on my color cyan. As you can see, the name pops up right here. I click OK. Dimensions, I usually put them as yellow. Now it's not cast in stone as to what color you can put or you should put your layers in, but it is really up to you to choose the color that you want. Okay, for this one I'm going to choose a kind of orange color. It's actually color number 30. Now one thing I should also say is that if you don't know the name of the color and you know the number of the color, you can actually type the number in here. So I can just type a random number and the color is going to change at once. So just clicking on that again, it shows me what color is color number 70. Alright, so I'm going to go back to 30 for my purposes here. Then construction at 2, we can just also choose another random color. Construction at 3, okay, let's give it a deep purple color. And then text, I usually like my text as green, so I'm gonna choose green and press OK. And we are done editing our layer properties. Now one thing I should also mention, in fact let me close this window so that I can explain this. Now that we have edited our layers, we can start drawing and change our layers based on the layer that we are drawing in. So right now we are in the zero layer, whatever that is, and from here when we click on this arrow, all our layers are going to come into view, and by the click of a mouse we can change that layer. So we're going to start with the construction lines layer. So just for our purposes, just for demonstration purposes, I'm gonna draw a quick shape here in my construction lines layer. I'm gonna change over to my construction arc layer and I'm going to do another quick shape here just for demonstration. I did an arc, and then I'm going to go over to object lines and I'm going to do another quick shape so that you can see. So we can actually see the different colors coming into play to actually tell us what layer we are in. And finally, I'm just, of course for demonstration purposes, I'm going to put some text here. I'm just gonna put the word text just for instance, and let us see how we can actually use the layer properties to our advantage. Now what I didn't explain in the previous set of information I gave is that you can also turn your layers on and off. So that is actually the advantage that you can have with this feature in AutoCAD. Say for example you want to only show your construction lines. So here's what we're going to do. In this column we have some light bulbs, and these light bulbs control whether the layer is on or off. So I want to turn off my construction arc layer, my construction lines layer, and my text. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna click on the light bulb, and one time we can actually see, we can already see the arc disappear. Yeah, I'm going to click on my construction lines layer, the light bulb that is, and the construction lines has now disappeared. I'm going to click on my text layer. Oops, okay, so there's something that will also come up. If we already have the layer on and we're trying to turn it off, the warning is going to come up to tell us that our layer is on and that we should be aware whether we want to turn it off. Okay, so I'm going to keep the current layer on, and I'm going to go back to this drop down list here, and I'm going to select object lines because that is the only layer that I want to be into view right now. So it needs to be active so that the command can work, the on and off command can work. So I'm going to click my object lines. I'm going to go back here and click my text, and now we can see it disappeared, so that means it works. So I'm only seeing my object lines in the interface, so it shows that I can actually edit. I can edit my object lines without affecting the layers that I turn off. Okay, so now that I'm done editing my object lines, I can go back and turn my layers on. So as you can see, the layers were untouched, they were unedited, and that was because of the use of my layer properties. So there you have it. That is a basic introduction of doing plane and solid geometry in AutoCAD. So this is just the first video in a series of videos that I'm gonna create, and these videos are gonna show you how you can do plane and solid geometry in AutoCAD. So the next video is gonna be basic geometry constructions, and I hope that you are going to stay tuned for that video. So thank you for watching, and if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe in order to follow this series, and also ring that bell so that as soon as that video is uploaded and it's ready, that you'll be able to view it and hopefully use it in your classroom or for your own learning experience. So thank you very much, and take care.